Let's talk today about the Islamic Golden Age, because if you start discussing Islam with some intellectuals, they're always going to bring up the wonderful Golden Age. As a matter of fact, I stood in a professor's office in Princeton University who told me that the high point of all human history was the Golden Age of Islam in Baghdad. Let's look at this a little bit. First off, this whole idea of the wonder of the Golden Age of Baghdad came from Europe, in particular those who are harshly critical of the Catholic Church, people like Voltaire. So by building Islam up, they could then point to the Dark Ages and the Catholic Church and say, see, that is so terrible. Look, this is just wonderful. So that's the contrast they wanted to do there in an attack on the Catholic Church. Now, there's another reason that we hear about the Golden Age, and that's because when we look around us, what do we see that comes out of Islam that is wonderful? Like, what wonderful novel have you read by a Muslim? I'm a scientist, and one of the things that I keep up with is, what are they giving Nobel Prizes for? They do not give Nobel Prizes to Muslim scientists working in Muslim lands. There's been a handful who've won Nobel Prizes for science, but they were working with kafirs, unbelievers, and in a kafir land. So we see here that Islam does not give us a lot of creativity. It can do some routine work. Here's take another example. What wonderful technological device do you use that comes from Islam? There are many Muslims in the computer business, but what great software do you use that comes out of Islam? There's a reason for this, and actually the reason for this comes from, of all things, the Golden Age. But before I get into the Golden Age, I want to show you what else was going on during this wonderful time of human history, which was that Islam was constantly attacking Europe. I prepared a dynamic battle map, which I want to show you here. And what you'll see is battles occurring, and you'll see that there's an unfolding history here. The white dots are the battles happening in the current 20-year period. So we're going to show you how Islam was harming Kafirs from the period of 750 AD to 1260 AD, which was what the time of the Golden Age was. So here we go, our first 20-year period. Now then you see another 20-year period. Notice that Islam is projecting force from Baghdad in Iraq across the Mediterranean. And notice how many battles there are. By the way, many of these battles culminate in the taking of slaves. A not largely known fact is that Muslims captured over 1 million Europeans to bring them into the slave quarters of Islam. Notice that Spain is continually being hammered. And all of this is happening during the Golden Age of Islam. You see, one of the reasons that there was a Golden Age was that Islam was conquering a lot of territory, and they could bring intellectuals from all different cultures together, so that there was some good things that happened when these different cultures were brought together by force, as it were, in Iraq. So these are the wars that Islam was fighting during the Golden Age. Now my question for you is, why are all those battles so golden? Let's take it another aspect of what was supposed to be so good about the Golden Age, which was they preserved all the Greek and Roman material. They did not preserve it all. They only preserved certain parts of it, which was useful for themselves. They didn't save any of the literature or the art. And as a matter of fact, they destroyed 90% of what they found. Why is it that saving 10% of the intellectual treasure of the classical period is called a Golden Age? What are we to call the Greeks and Romans who had 100% of it? Why aren't they referred to as a Golden Age? Now, by the way, the rest of the doctrine found from the Greeks and the Romans was in the Byzantine Empire, and it finally really got to Europe when, why? Well, the Muslims crushed Constantinople and the scholars had to flee. So there was some good that was done, but these are more like golden flecks. There were areas in which they did well. One was geography, star maps, mathematics, but it was very limited as to what the Golden Age actually occurred. The knowledge that was brought forth in the Golden Age was very limited to the area that it was in. By the way, one of the things that came out of the Golden Age was the philosophy is there is no cause and effect and there are no natural laws. Now let's go back to the lack of Nobel Prizes in Islamic countries. Do you think that saying there's no natural laws and there's no cause and effect would make a good scientist? No. All of science is based on the search for natural laws, and it is based upon cause and effect. So we can say about the Golden Age that there were some golden flecks, but it was not a golden age, and it all came at the hands of the suffering of the kafir. so much for the Golden Age. Thank you.